here's some of the stuff we're going to be running today. These are transformers. We have a bunch of different sizes here. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to put them through the hammer mill with a half inch screen. All these little steel plates are going to break apart. And the copper windings are going to be blown apart as well. So we separate all the metal. The paper and the varnish and plastic is going to separate as well. Once it comes out of the hammer mill, it'll run up a conveyor and under a mag belt, pull the steel plates out, and then it'll fall down through a zigzag, and it's going to suck all the paper and the fluff and the plastic out, and we'll have clean copper out the bottom. These weigh anywhere from a couple pounds, this one might be out of a little microwave or something, up to this one weighs 14 pounds. Comes out of the big light ballast you see hanging in big warehouses and shops and stuff. So there's a whole range of sizes and weights here, and we'll see what happens when we run through the hammer mill. Done with our test run, and so we'll come over and take a look at the steel first. This is the stuff the mag belt pulled out, and you can see it's really, really clean. I don't see any copper wire in any of this, so we get really, really good separation. We'll go over here and take a look at the copper portion now, and we did it in two steps. We did the small transformers first. Here's a look at one of the small transformers for scale. And what we found is that the small transformers have really, really fine wire in it. And the zigzag did a pretty good job of getting the paper out of the wire. We were having a few problems with some of the insulated wire, just like this stuff hanging off. We didn't clip any of that off. The hammer mill doesn't strip the insulation, and so this is heavy enough to fall down through with the copper wire. Here's a close-up look of the small transformers. And we ran a few bigger ones in there too, so there's some bigger copper. But it's pretty clean. Most of the coloration you see in there is the insulated wires that still have copper in them. But when we ran this, we wanted to make real sure that we didn't suck up any of the fine copper wire with the fluff and the varnish. So here's the 3-horsepower dust collector. And we'll look in the bottom bag here. This is where all the fluff and varnish and plastic went. And you can see it's really pretty clean. There's every once in a while there's a little piece of copper wire in there. It probably got hung up on a piece of fluff. There's some in there, I think you can see. But the overall weight of this bag is hardly anything. And so I don't think we lost very much copper at all, maybe a couple percent at the most. But there's no reason you couldn't reprocess this either through a granulator and then over an air table or even a wet table and get the remaining copper out if you had enough of it. So here's what we found with the bigger transformers. And I kind of busted this one up a little bit so you could see. The wire in this is actually pretty good size wire. It's pretty heavy gauge. And this is what it looks like when it comes out of the hammer mill all clean. And I think this is actually probably number one because of its size. And we had the same problem. We weren't clipping off the wires off the transformers. So we had the insulated copper still comes through. And every once in a while you'll get a heavier piece of plastic. The thing that I want to try next time with this is the wire is so heavy gauge that I could really increase the sucker, the air velocity in the zigzag, and I could probably, if I couldn't suck these out, I'd be surprised and separate them. But we could get a little bit more of this fluff out of here, some of this heavier plastic on the bigger transformers would suck out without any copper loss. So we're still in the R&D phase, the testing phase, but I think these are really good results, and I'll be interested to hear from you guys what you think of this. So that'll wrap up this video, and like I said earlier, we're still in kind of the R&D phase of this whole thing, trying to figure out exactly the best way to proceed and how to get a clean copper product out the bottom so you guys can sell it and make more money. There's a limit to what this size hammer mill can take. This is a 24 inch by 16 inch hammer mill. And these 14 or 15 pound transformers may be just a little bit too big for running production. They do okay, but if you're gonna be running day in, day out, you might wanna reduce that to like maybe an 8 or 10 pound maximum transformer. We do have a larger hammer mill in the works. So I'll be really interested to hear from you guys. How big a transformers do you need to process, and then we can build the equipment accordingly. Is a 15 pound big enough? Do you need to do 25 pound transformers? I'm sure everybody's going to be a little bit different, but appreciate your feedback. I appreciate you guys watching the videos, and we have fun making the equipment, and look forward to hearing from you guys and seeing you on the next video. So thanks for watching.